So, as you just take a moment to begin to drift comfortably asleep, I don't know whether you'll drift asleep faster to the sound of my voice or whether it'll be to the spaces between my words. As you comfortably drift asleep, I'm just going to tell this sleep story in the background. And you find yourself on holiday in the Mediterranean. And as you're walking around exploring, enjoying the most beautiful blue water of lakes and the ocean, enjoying the most beautiful blue sky and wispy white clouds, and enjoying the warmth of the sun on your face, and encounters with cats, with dogs, with other animals. And enjoying a horse ride out to a distant location. You then set up camp in this distant location on the edge of a lake. And in this camp, you set up a camera. And you're tucked away so as to allow nature to take its course, to not scare off any of the animals, to keep yourself as hidden as possible. And from this space, you take photographs of different birds. You manage to take photographs of some birds flying high in the sky, some birds on the lake, some coming into land on the water, some seeming to run on the water to try and take off into the sky, and other animals coming down to the water to drink. And you keep yourself hidden and quiet while enjoying taking these photos. And then you see the strangest of sights, something that you've never seen before. You see a very large pelican land in the water. And it's so large, you wonder how it managed to fly. And you've seen other pelicans before, with their smooth plumage, looking so graceful in the way they stand, tall. And yet this one, as you zoom in to take a photo of its face, looks like a parent had just placed a bowl on its head and given it a bowl cut haircut and then scruffed up its hair. And unlike other pelicans you had seen, this one seemed to have a scruffy hairstyle. And so you took plenty of photos while it went about its business in the water, catching fish, seeming to keep itself to itself, just quietly moving around. And yet you are really drawn in by the fact that to you it looked like it had this strange hairstyle. And after taking the photos, you watched as this enormous bird managed to struggle its way into the sky and take off and fly and disappeared from view. And as the sun set, so you lit a campfire, had yourself some food, and then rested in your tent, reviewing the photographs that you had taken, still curious about that pelican with the strange haircut, how large it seemed to be, that it seemed to easily stand taller than a child. And its wings, when it launched into the air, were probably twice the length of a child. And it looked bigger and heavier than something which should have been able to fly. And you had never encountered something with what looked like such a strange head of hair. And you wondered to yourself what that scruffy hairstyle of feathers must mean, what its purpose is for that pelican. And you reviewed your photos before settling down and drifting and floating so deeply, so comfortably asleep. And the next day, you looked out to see if you could see that same pelican again. And you didn't see it that day, before you had to pack away and head back off on the horse and continue your holiday here in the Mediterranean. And you explored many places around the Mediterranean, exploring old ruins on different islands, seeing colourful birds, all different types of birds, all different types of birds, always on the lookout for more of those pelicans with the strange hairstyles. Curious about why they have that hair. Curious about them and their size. And then one day, you stumble across a lake where you see that they're actually far more common than perhaps you'd first thought when you only saw one on its own. And you manage to take plenty of photos of graceful pelicans with their smooth plumage, and of these larger pelicans with the messy feathers on top of their heads. Photos of pelicans walking in the water, catching fish, taking off and landing, and flocks of pelicans all flying together. And after your Mediterranean holiday and your encounter with these different pelicans, you headed home. And once home, it felt good to be back in your own home. You packed everything away. And that night, there was something magical about settling down into your own bed and drifting and floating comfortably asleep in your own bed. And while you comfortably drifted and floated asleep, so you began to dream with a smile, dreaming about these animals, about those pelicans, and them seeming to have human-like characteristics, hearing them talk with you and interact in some kind of magical land in your dreams. Hearing the voice of the pelican with the funny hair and the slightly posher voice of the pelicans who look smart and prim and proper. And the sounds of the horse talking on the shore. And this creation of your mind as you drifted and floated asleep brought a smile to you as you fell gently and peacefully and relaxed asleep all night long.